we found out many years ago, because that one-stop shop music shop that we have for stock music, but it's the same mechanism that you just can buy proper original music from real artists.
Yeah.
But by just going to a website, click, find, swipe credit card, download, and continue your project. Like, you know, easy step, bam. And when we had musicians signing up, they were sending us some really cool original music, like proper original stuff that you could never hear on Spotify or whatsoever. But in some cases, it was also not the music that you would listen to, for example, if you were going dining or shopping, like background music services. It was super aggressive, or the lyrics were like, you know, in there. And we had other people who said like, but actually what I can do is I can actually deliver you good quality music, well recorded, and it will be suitable for a hotel chain, or it will be suitable for a chain of restaurants. And we're like, huh, this is interesting. Mm-hmm. Let's say if we have enough musicians on Free Music Archive, a Tribe of Noise, that can actually bundle together, and we curate music playlist for shopping malls, or we curate music for all the other kind under Creative Commons, in a way that if we curate and offer, you know, it's normalized, the music, and there's a journey between them. The Monday morning sounds different than the Wednesday afternoon. You know, we do the whole work like a radio show. And then we offer that package to like a retail group. And we say like, okay, you have 100 stores, you pay $20 per month per store, and we deliver you great quality music. And that money is shared directly with the participating artist, without ASCAP and BMI and record labels and publishers. Like, directly some of the money goes to the musicians.
Mm-hmm.
And they were like, huh, this is super interesting, because the retail owner saves money, because it's cheaper to go directly to the source, of course, than to pay all the middlemen. The musician gets more, because it's, you know, we monitor what music is being played, and the artist gets paid directly or that same month, as opposed to like 2 years down the line.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, we started doing that model in 2013.
Oh, really?
And it's still going and growing throughout Europe, and we have some customers in the States now.
Mm-hmm.
And that's super funny. And with Creative Commons music, so, you know, when we talked to Creative Commons headquarters and explained this model, they go like, damn, this, you know, of course you can go commercial with Creative Commons. The only thing, you know, you package in a different way. You actually, people are paying for the service and not per se for the curated, for the content license itself.
It goes back again to one of the reasons Creative Commons started was because of music downloading. Well, music downloading isn't really a thing anymore. You know, it was people downloading music and sharing it. And now it's just like, oh, I just have Spotify. You know, you don't have to do it anymore. Now downloading music, it's like, it's good to have your license on there, but they're only downloading it to use it for something. They don't want to have to go, oh, I have to make sure this MP3 is available on my phone. You know, going back to what you were saying about the restaurant thing, that's also another aspect how to get paid, and it's not necessarily going to has to be used online. It's used in the background. Our band has actually had our stuff in a catalog like that for years. And it's funny. It took me a while to realize why they kept denying some of our songs. And then exactly what you said, it's like some of them be like, well, that's not going to play in the background of a hotel in Poland. You know, that's, that's way too aggressive. But that's speaking to that. That's really neat that I get paid a certain amount and see that stuff, like our music is in the background in Poland. And on top of it, what happens is that explained, or it explained later on, why we kept getting these weird Shazams of our songs in different parts of countries and, you know, places all over the world. And I'm like, why would they Shazam a song? Like, are they, and then it occurred to me, oh yeah, they'd be in this public place and go, what song is this? And they'd hold up their Shazam and find it and then download it off of, you know, iTunes. Like, this cycle still happens. Like, those are the reasons that I love Creative Commons, because of that.
Yep.
And the reason it's getting played is because it's also a way to get around GEMA laws, because you have to pay so much for, if there's like more, what is it, like more than 11 people in a room, you have to like pay GEMA fees or something like that if you have music playing.
It depends per country. So that's the other thing. Like, you know, in the States, it's pretty straightforward. You have your ASCAP and your BMI and your CSEC.
Yeah.
Many of those music providers, they include it in a fee. So it's like a all-in-one package that you just throw at the end customer.
Yeah.
In Europe, every single country has its own ASCAP, has its own. Mm-hmm. We have something in Europe called neighboring rights organizations. So they actually collect money for the performing artists as opposed to the composer or the lyricist. Mm. And they have like all their different rules. So in some cases, it's like, you know, if it's not your family or it's not your relatives, you do have to pay no matter what. They actually in the Netherlands tried to force, taxi drivers to pay because they go like, hey, if you put on the radio in your taxi, that's a professional kind of environment. Somebody, you know, in the back is enjoying it and therefore you're offering a service and therefore you have to pay us. Well, guess what? Taxi drivers were not willing to pay for it. So, that didn't work. But every single country has that thing to it. It does take a lot of resources on our side because we have to, convince like countries that Creative Commons actually is an alternative for, mm-hmm. you know, rights managed music, FIAD, all these performing rights organizations. So for the last 10 years, I have been spending a lot of time explaining it to many organizations that Creative Commons has that, is a legal entity to actually share content, use content. We still have to explain to a lot of people that there are subsets of Creative Commons that can actually be used for commercial use. So a lot of people around the world still relate to Creative Commons as that, yeah, of course, that, you know, the bunch of foolish people that just give away their stuff.
Right.
No, it's not. And you know, to be completely open, because I'm also the chairman of the board of an organization in the Netherlands called Open Netherlands, which is the Dutch representatives of Creative Commons. Nice. So we work a lot with Creative Commons licensing and open licenses in general. And I think just a lot of people still need to see that we need open alternatives in this market today. We really need them. Because musicians and how the internet is moving forward, and also with Facebook being a silo and Google being a silo, and mm-hmm. you know, it's almost like if you're not one of them, you're against them. So it's super difficult for creative to move through the internet and try to, you know, determine how to make money, how to give away stuff, how to, you know, it's super tough for a lot of people, and we have to explain to all these groups that there are great alternatives with open licensing, mm-hmm. from give it away for free all the way to make maybe not a shitload of money, but, you know, make decent cash.
Right.
And I'm super proud. We do have artists on Tribe of Noise, and now also from Free Music Archive, mm-hmm. who came from Free Music Archive, still are on the Free Music Archive, but also just embrace some of the business models that we have on Tribe of Noise and go like, this is so fun. Some of my stuff is just moving around the globe free of charge. Some of the stuff people have to pay for. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, Tribe of Noise will tell them to buy a license.